Daisy here with another layout for COAPA Cut Files, Confessions of a Paper Addict. And today I am using the beautiful typewriter with these florals on it. So I cut it out using my Silhouette on and some black cardstock. And then I did cut the top paper part off. And I did that for two reasons. One, because I didn't want to rip. Excuse me. Oh my gosh. I didn't want to rip any of those flowers off. And I thought it would be easier to work with just like this part. And then also I have an idea, which you'll see coming up. So I am using this old, I think it's Maggie Holmes paper that I've had in my stash. I am using all scraps here, and I just glued that in. I'm highlighting certain phrases that are highlighted on the paper, obviously. And then while that is drying, I'm going to add these are printables from Amy Tangerine. Amy, yeah, I think so. And I'm just filling in the centers of each of the flowers. Then I'm going to jump back to my typewriter. So what I'm doing is I'm letting the glue dry just enough that I can cut around with my scissors without it shifting a lot. And I am not one who thoroughly enjoys backing cut files. I do like backing bigger pieces like this. I find them much easier and it's more satisfying for me. Doing the little, you know, one tiny piece for every little section, that's where I lose my patience. But yeah, doing this kind of thing is actually lots of fun. And then I am going to trim around the yellow parts of the flowers and then decide here. I pulled out a bunch of colors that I liked. Again, from my scrap stash. And yeah, I just had fun. I pulled out things that I enjoyed. I really kind of started with that typewriter paper, that Maggie Holmes ones, and then I pulled out colors that kind of went with that. So I'm going for pink flowers. And so I'm just taking some of these scraps. That one I just used was from, I'm pretty sure it was from Paige Evans. This one is a Vicki Booten one. That one I believe is Recollections. I believe. And I really like the kind of purpley pink on there, so I'm adding that. And I'm just gluing them to all of the flowers, and then I'm going to trim around the flowers. I just, for me, I find that that's the easiest. Because it just is for me. So and then I'm using this Heidi Swap Art Walk paper. And I think I used the polka dots, which that I think is another Vicki Booten paper, maybe. No, is it? I don't know. I'm not sure where the polka dots are from. But anyway, just trimming around, trying to get everything neat, trying to get in the little nooks and crannies so you don't see all of the little jaggedy pieces. You can use like an X-Acto knife, but I have a very... I have to find my replacement blades because mine is so old. It's got a little rust on it. The tip broke off. So yeah, I don't rely on that. But these Cutter Bee scissors are amazing. I highly recommend them. 10 out of 10. I got mine on Amazon for like $8 or $10 or something like that. So just trimming around. I did speed this up to about 5 times, but it's still, you know, there's a lot of bits on here that I'm going through. So I do apologize I didn't speed it up any faster. I'm using the other side of that art walk paper for one of the flowers, and then I'm going to use that other polka dot paper, I believe. I know I was thinking about not using it because then I just used polka dots, but yep, there it goes. Adding it anyway. So I'm going to set those aside, let those dry, and then I lost some of my video. So here we go, showing you everything. So my idea here, I have this piece of parchment paper from Cardstock Warehouse. It is thicker than vellum, and I have rolled the top to make it look like it's a piece of paper that's coming out of a typewriter and rolling up on itself. And I am using this typewriter stamp set that is Miss Sparkle & Co. I'm not sure. I got it. Somebody, it was a gift. And I love this stamp so much. So I'm using some stays on ink because I am stamping on this parchment paper, which is a little bit different texture. And just putting my title, which is just my type. And I am doing a picture today of my daughter and her boyfriend. And this is the first time I have scrapbooked them. I did put washi tape over his face, just in case anybody's curious. Just because, you know, I don't have permission to use him on YouTube. So I am going to be very mindful of that. And now I'm just working on this. So you see, with the original cut file, the flowers came up over the top of the paper just like that, that was sticking out. And I decided to kind of tilt it over to the side just slightly so that you could see the paper behind it, see the, you know, typing. And then I found this little scrap of gold foil paper, and I am just kind of putting that. That's a gold foil heart vellum. And then I decided I want to stitch on here. So I pulled out my sewing machine, and this is just a Project Runway Special Brother machine that was at Walmart. I bought it about 12 years ago. It was like $100 or something. Works great for sewing and sewing on paper. So I'm just going back and forth using this gold metallic thread. Just back and forth, back and forth. And that's how I'm adhering that those papers together. And then I decided I want to do a gold border. So to do that, I am just doing a straight stitch. I do increase my stitch length to 4.5 or 5, just to make sure that it's not too tight and it's not pulling on the paper too hard. But while I'm finishing the stitching, if you don't already belong to the Confessions of a Paper Addict Facebook group, I have a link down below. That's where you can find the free cut file for every month. It's only available in that group for that month. So January's cut file is up until the 31st of January, New Zealand time. So if you're here in the States, they are a day ahead of us. So if you log in on the 31st in the States, you're going to be too late because it's already the first there. So be mindful of that. But it is very, very generous of Virginia to give us access to, you know, a free cut file every single month. And then if you want it after that, it is still available in the shop, which is also nice. So now I am using these little phrase stamps. I just stamped on the back of the paper just to see how it was going to turn out. And these are from Ellie Studio. And I just picked some of the phrases that worked out really well. And I'm just going to stamp those around the background a little bit. So again, head on over to the Facebook, join that. COAPA cut files is on Etsy. It's Virginia's shop. She has over 1,000 cut files now. You guys, that is amazing, and they're all beautiful. And there's, you know, cut files for every occasion, every, you know, different thing you could possibly want. And she really, really does a beautiful job. I love her florals. And then I also love, she does build a cut files. This is not a build a cut file, but you know, a little sidetrack here. Build a cut files is something that she does quite a bit of, and there are so many options where you can build your own scene, build your own wreath, build your own, you know, whatever. And it gives you options where you can create basically your own little die cuts using these cut files, and they are amazing. So highly recommend. Head on over Links will be down below. And now I'm just going in with these Good Vibes stamps. I had to have these stamps when they came out, right? Everybody had these stamps, and I absolutely love them, and I never ever use them. So this year we are using the stuff. I'm pulling out my scraps, I'm pulling out my stamps. We are gonna get it done. I don't know what done, but you know, it's gonna be done. And I'm just stamping around here. I'm sorry, I'm starting to lose my voice. I've had pneumonia for the last week, and for the 2 weeks before that I had COVID, and it just does not seem to want to end ever. But anyhow, just filling in some of the spots. I'm not trying to be super like straight or anything like that. I just want to make sure that it's kind of filled in. So I'm just adding a couple here and there just to see, you know, just to see how I like it. And somehow I got off center. Like I wasn't centered correctly. Because I keep moving the typewriter, right? And then I don't put it completely back. So then I'm trying to like fix that when I realize that that's what I've done. Whatever. It is what it is. It's fine. I love how this turned out. Actually, my daughter really loves it too. She wants to keep it. So she's thinking about taking it and hanging it up in her bedroom. So I'm just clearing these off. I did also want to add a couple of extra flowers. And I thought these flowers, these are by Hampton Art. They went really well with the ones that Virginia had designed. So I thought I would add a couple of those in. I'm going to add some of the little dotty leaf things. I don't know. Whatever those are. You know, those little branch things. And then I realized, oh, they just have little dots. Let's just do that instead. So, yeah, gonna add the little dots around. I think I add something else too. I think I find a heart somewhere that I'm gonna add. Yep. This is the Never Grow Up stamp set. I really love buying stamp sets, and I really just need to use them more because, you know, you can make them your own. You can use them however you want, right? And I just have to pull them out more. I don't know why I don't. So now I'm trying to fix this, realizing it's a little off, seeing how I can fix that. And you can see my gold thread got a little junked up there on the bottom, but it's okay. It's on the bottom. Nobody's gonna see it. I did, when I curled my paper, I used liquid adhesive and ATG just to make sure. And then I also curled it so that it was a little off to the side so that you could see what was going on. And then I used my X-Acto knife here and slit a little area where I could tuck the picture into the typewriter because I wanted to make sure you could see some of that heart piece. And yeah, that was just the best way I could figure out without covering up the typewriter. And then just tucking the flowers back almost where they belong, just a little over. And I'm just going to glue everything down now, make sure that it's all stuck down really well. And then I am going to come in with some Spiegelbaum scrap sequins, and I just pull in some of the pinks to go with the colors that I used already. Yeah, because I did stick with pink and gold pretty much for most of this. But I don't know if you can see it in the space bar. It says, I love everything about this. I thought that was perfect. So I purposely, you know, tried to frame that in. But yeah, I'm going to add these sequins. I thought that I add kind of the iridescent ones more than the pink ones. I think that they just add a little something extra to this page. And then that's pretty much going to be the end of my layout. So I want to thank you so much for watching. If you, again, want to check out the shop, please do. The link is down below in the description box. Head on over, join the Facebook group. I'm so excited for, you know, all the new things that are coming out. So definitely that's where you want to be to find out when the new releases are going to be released. And also, if there's any sales or anything, you're going to find out about it first in the Facebook group. So definitely check that out. But I want to thank you so much for watching. I hope everybody's staying healthy and safe and having a good new year. I will see you again next time. Bye.